So we're brought here today by the Touch by Chris Foundation, which of course is in memory and in support of workplace safety after the tragic loss of Chris Cassaniti.
What Trish and Rob Cassaniti have done is extraordinary, where they have used their grief, their devastation, and they have turned that into getting out there and educating the community, working in with community, but also being very strong advocates on behalf of other families who've lost loved ones.
I've been a close admirer of the foundation that she started up, considering I was one of the first responders that attended Christopher's fatality back on the 1st of April 2019. It is very important, and a lot of people need to acknowledge that and recognise that, that we come to work and we don't go to work to not come home to our families.
What I love about Patricia and her perspective is she really wants to provide that genuine care for people who have had the experience of losing a loved one in a workplace accident. And it's a first time opportunity for people who are often at odds with not only recovering from the trauma, but dealing with the difficulty of how they get on with their lives.
I think it's very important that we all support organisations like Touch by Christopher. I think we need to keep WHS out there. It affects every single business, every single worker. I don't care what sort of industry you're in. I think a lot of people think that workplace health and safety is only for mining and construction. When things do go wrong, there isn't a lot of support out there for families. So it's really important that we support the work that Patricia and the team are doing.
The vision for the future for me is that the government and agencies are really out there supporting people in the wake of a critical incident. There aren't enough support services for people who have experienced trauma to do with a workplace accident.
We will be working hard with Trish and Rob Cassaniti, with other advocates, with injured workers, with industry, with unions, with the community, to get that message out there. We are going to crack down on those who do the wrong thing on work sites, in construction, all across New South Wales.
And we're hoping that the government, state and federal and local government take seriously and put rules and procedure in place so those similar accidents never happens.
Everybody has a right to come home from a day's work safely and in one piece.